Lots of websites these days contain rich internet content, such as what can be done with Flex. In fact, Flex may now be one of the preferred technologies to develop rich web UIs. Because of that, it's critical that when you're load testing such a site, that the tool you use understands the protocols that are used in Flex applications. And that tool should also provide you with a set of options that you can use to control and observe the data that's being sent during the load test. LoadComplete has a dedicated module just for Flex based on direct support for the AMF transport used within Flex applications, and it also includes a number of wizards to set and analyze the data used in the scenario. In this video, I'll show you how to set up a load test for a Flex application with LoadComplete. We will first record a specific user scenario, showing how an application could be used, and then we'll scale it up to 50 virtual users that will execute our scenario, but with different data, thus approximating real-life usage. So I've got a sample little Flex app right here, and what this does is it's a contact manager. So we're going to add a bunch of new contacts into our system and then record that traffic and have LoadComplete replay it as if it's coming from 50 different users. All right, so here's how we do that. We start out by recording the traffic that's going to go back and forth over the wire to our server. So we're going to click this Record New User Scenario button. And that brings up this Create New Project wizard. And a project is just a collection of related load tests and any relevant supporting data. So I'm just going to give this a more descriptive name here. I'm going to call this the Flex Load Test Project and say Next. Okay. Now, want to put in the IP address or the DNS name of the server that we're monitoring. In this case, it's called Zeta. We'll click Next. And now we can specify some quality of service metrics for our test. And what these mean are all of our pages should load within this amount of time, right here, 5 seconds, and every request we send to the server should be responded to within this amount of time, 2 seconds. Now, I know right now that because my app is still in development, it's running a little slow, so I'm going to bump these values up a little bit. Okay, now we get this record user scenario. Now, all the traffic that goes back and forth over the wire is captured and stored in a special file, which we call a scenario. And so this is going to be the Flex load scenario. And then a scenario is replayed from a test. As you can see right here, we can give a name for that. So we'll call this the Flex load test. So the scenario creates the traffic. The test actually sends the traffic on to the server. Okay. Now, once we've got that set up, we come in here to this open URL box, and I'm going to paste in the URL to my website. Say record now. Okay, and LoadComplete goes into record mode, and it launches the browser out to the target URL, and now we can interact with our application as normal. Now, keep in mind, LoadComplete isn't recording keystrokes and mouse clicks. It's only recording the data that's being posted and received from the server. So what we're going to do is click Add new record here, and I'm going to add a new contact into my system. So Barry, and the last name is Alan, and his email address is cc@abcd.com. And we'll click Add. Okay, so now Barry's been added into our system. We're going to click this Get button just to fetch the records back, make sure we got him. There he is. Fantastic. So that worked successfully. So that's everything we want to do to load test. We're going to stop recording now. And LoadComplete renders all that traffic that we just recorded right here in this scenario file. So I'm going to expand this guy a bit. Now what you're seeing here inside the scenario file is a list of all the requests and responses that went back and forth over the wire during the course of that recording. So right here, this is just getting the initial page. And then here, this is where we're loading that Flex grid for the first time. And then here, this is where we're posting our data. In fact, if you come down here, you can see here's where we're putting in our name, our email address, and our last name. So all those values were captured by LoadComplete. The other thing to mention is that all the data that you're looking at right now, this is the exact information that's being sent via the AMF protocol. So I mentioned earlier that LoadComplete has full support for the AMF protocol, and you can see it in action right here on this screen. All right, so now we're going to be able to replay that traffic as if it's coming from multiple people and we'll be able to parameterize it so that each virtual user who sends traffic will be sending their own unique name and email address. So once we've got the scenario created, what we want to do is verify it. And we verify it just by right-clicking and saying verify. And what this is going to do is just replay the traffic as if it's coming from one user, just to make sure that everything runs cleanly. Because if you have problems running with one user, well, you're going to have problems running with multiple users. Okay, I fast-forwarded a bit, and you can see that our results have been generated. And the thing I want to call your attention to is right here. This test duration is currently marked at 14 seconds. Now, we know that there's no way it took that long to post one user into my system. So what we're going to do is come back to the scenario here, and you'll notice that there's some values listed in this think time column. And what think time is an amount of time that a user pauses before submitting additional data. So right here, we paused for 6 seconds before we continued on. That's not really indicative of a real user scenario, so I'm just going to right-click and say change think time. And I'm going to bump that down to half a second. And now when we re-verify that scenario, I'll just do that again real quick, we'll see that our results come back a whole lot faster. Okay, I fast-forwarded a bit, and now we can see that it takes 6.9 seconds to run this test as opposed to just over 14 seconds. So that's all set. Okay, so now that we've gotten our run settings good, we want to parameterize this traffic so that each user who goes and submits data to our website is using information other than Barry Allen with a email address of cc@abcd.com. Here's how we're going to do that. Come over here to this scenarios node and double click on it. And that brings up this variables pane. I'm just going to click the new button right here. And I'm going to create a new variable. And my new variable is going to be called first name. Let's say next. Now there's a bunch of different types of variables that LoadComplete can work with. But the one that I'm interested in right now is called a list variable, because that's going to give us back a value from a list. And well, you say, well, Nick, you don't have a list. Ah, but I can click Generate and have LoadComplete make one for me. So I want LoadComplete to make 50 first names. So I type in 50 into the number of rows. In data type, we go to name. Gender we can leave as male or female. And name kind is going to be first. And you can see a sample of the data right here. All right, so we're going to have 50 first names. Say next. And then we want item index equals virtual user index to be selected. That means that virtual user number 1 gets name number 1. Virtual user 2 gets name number 2, and so on. And we say finish. All right, we're going to do it again. This time, we're going to make a last name variable. Again, we're going to choose list variable. And again, we're going to have LoadComplete generate 50 last names for us. So again, data type is name. This time around, though, it's last names. Say OK. Next. And finish. Once more for the email address. Same process. LoadComplete can generate a whole bunch of different types of data for you, whether it's email addresses, names, GUIDs, passwords, you name it, Complete can build it. So there we go. Click OK here. Next and finish. So now we've got our 3 bits of data specified for use in our load test. Okay, so now we'll click Save. We'll jump back into our scenario now. And I'm going to come down here. And you see we've got this replace with variable column. All right, so instead of using the last name of Alan every time, we're going to use whatever's in the last name column. And then here for the email address, same thing. We're going to use the email. And then we're going to use the first name variable for here. Now we'll click Save. Okay, so now our traffic's been parameterized so that each user is going to have a unique username and email address. All right, fantastic. Now what we're going to do is open up this tests node. We're going to double click on the Flex Load Test project. And we're going to change the user count here to 50. We'll click Save. And then we'll say run this load test. And now LoadComplete's going to fire off and it's going to run each one of those users. Okay, I fast-forwarded a bit and our test has finished. You can see that it took just over a minute to execute this test for all 50 of those users. Everything ran successfully. All right, now what I want to show you, though, is over here on the Messages tab. This is going to give you a list of every request and response that was sent and received during the course of our load test. And right here, look at request number 8. This is saying it's a post request. Everything looks good. We got a 200 back. We were expecting a 200. We found a 200. Therefore, this request was successful, so that's great. But if you click on the bodies tab here, you can see the data that was being posted. And right here, you can see that we had a user whose last name was Hendrix. Their email address was norman@vulpitate.edu. And their first name was Courtney. So we aren't sending Barry Allen every time here. We are updating the data for each one of our users. In fact, if we look through another virtual user here on request number 8, we've got last name of Brock, first name of Nomalanga. And again, right here, last name of Birch, first name of Solomon. So the data is being updated for each individual virtual user. And now let's go back to our application here, and I'll just click Get Records. And you can see here's all of our new values that have been entered into our application. So we had way more than just Barry Allen going in on replay. So that's how you can load test Flex-based applications using LoadComplete. I hope you found this helpful. If you're interested in more videos on LoadComplete, head on up to our website at smartbear.com.